Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. We are of course going over to the Forest of Navel next. And I just noticed something. Look at how the numbers change. All three numbers don't bounce if the same digit in the same column is the same number. That's interesting. Anyway, let's start the Forest Navel. You have 15 minutes and 12 seconds here with a maximum Pikmin cap of 482. So let's get this started and see how many I can breed up here. I see... Oh, it's a bread bug. Wait, it's gonna go for those blue ones, isn't it? So I should probably start plucking these. Yeah, it is. Of course it is. Alright, no. Don't pluck any more than you have to, because I got a bread bug to squish. Well, not so much squish as it is get back to the base and then squish for the last little bit of damage. And just get these all out and raring to go. There we go. Let's see. I'm not sure how much I'm going to be able to explore in this area because it's going to be rather tricky, actually. Uh-oh. Well. Now that works. Why not? Everything should work out fine. I'll get one less Pikmin out of it, but I'm more focused on speed than anything, I suppose. Ooh, two five pellets here out of that. And wait a second. Can I, like, maximize stuff here for once? As long as I can, basically. There we go, and... Why did that one go over to the other one? I don't know. It's like the first group went to the pellet properly and the other ones didn't. I just can't rely on them, I swear. Okay, I need yellows for that. Nope, I said yellows. I threw that one a little too far. No, I want just the yellows. There we go. Nope. Dang it. And there we go. I didn't think that would be so difficult. Pluck away. Before I start getting out into the wild world, I must get ye ol' numbers up. And there we go. While they're taking those back, I'll pluck some more. Challenge mode, definitely very fun for getting a load of Pikmin, but obviously, as I said, not canon, but still fun. Wait, you're still working over here? Well, it's going to the reds, even though that blue one's been on it for like the past minute. Alright, I think I'm just about topped out here as to what I can do right at the beginning. Aside from, you know, the extra plucking. Hurry, Olimar! Hurry, Pikmin! Sprout! Sprout like you've never sprouted before! You gotta admit, though, that they really, really grow fast. I mean, they turn from seeds to, you know, just leaves and buds and flowers at a really rapid pace. It's amazing. They're either like bamboo, and that they grow really, really quickly. Okay, you guys pluck that. I've got stuff to pluck myself. By the way, I forgot to mention, Olimar, his name is based off of Mario, well, an anagram of it, basically, plus the letter L. I just thought you might find that interesting, maybe. So it's like, when you go with Nintendo, you're always, always led back to Mario in some way, shape, or form, or cameo, or whatever. Oh, shoot. Yellow. Get up there. If the rest of them... Oh, maybe that was a bad choice of movement. I think I'm gonna go around the other way, just so I can show you the rest of the place, because you've seen, I mean, you can see what's down in those pools just by being up here and whatnot. So, yeah, as I said, I'm mostly just doing the challenge mode stuff to show you how the place is like and whatnot in the new change, more difficult version, so to speak. Well, I wouldn't say it's more difficult because you get to breed more Pikmin and whatnot, but it is in the sense that you have to breed them in, you know, as many as you can in a certain amount of time. And... Oh, I had a red there, not a... Ugh, whatever. I kept going over to the blues. You could see me going over to the blues, but he just kept grabbing... Or kept going for other colors. Arr. and for good measure. Come on. Maybe I should be going over to the blues. There's still a bunch more there. And where is the rest of my team if they're not up here? Did some, like, flop over the edge or something like that? Because I don't think there's 65 up here. I guess there is. There certainly didn't seem like it. Alright, let's venture into the wild, wild west. And knock down this wall. That should speed stuff up when I have to breed some more Pikmin based on the wall's positioning. And wow, they're taking down the wall fast. Blue, please, for that pellet. No, not the yellow. No, not the yellow. No. I was standing in the middle of the blue. How could he possibly have grabbed the yellow? Is that worth getting that red pellet up there? Well, maybe if I'm going for the highest score possible, but as I said, I'm just showing the area and whatnot for the most part. Hey, I just noticed there's no fiery blowhogs around here. That's interesting. They're like the trademark of this beach area here. Huh. It's very interesting, I have to say. As I said, I'm not very knowledgeable on challenge mode, so this is definitely not surprising some people, but it's certainly surprising me. Because I haven't played in such a long time. I wonder if I should be building that bridge. Reds. No! I cannot get the color that I want here. There we go. I wonder if that, that puff stool is down there, because that gives me a lot of Pikmin. Yeah, I should be using a C-stick. Amateur mistake! Ooh, there's a 20 pellet up there, that's pretty nice. 20 pellet back here, that's really nice. It seems like things build or break down a lot faster in challenge mode than it does in, the regular story mode, but that might be because of the sake of time. And you are not being very helpful, are you? You guys. No! I tried to redirect them over there with the C-stick. Ah, well. They're done. They're done. Don't get squished by the bridge glitch. Oh, just went right through the bridge. That's better than the bridge glitch could ever be. That's a good kind of glitch. Blues! Over here. Pellets! In here. And that's a tricky pellet right there, because they want me to take it out of the water with the blues. Oh, geez, that's a 20. I don't have enough for that. They want me to take it out of the water with the blues and then take it back to the base with the yellows. There we go. They should be golden. I'm going to see what's over to the right over here. Yeah, right over here. That would be right on the map from the starting location. Ooh, honey wisp. Maybe I should flower. No! One landed on and I just frantically grabbed the others. It wasn't enough, man. It wasn't enough. Or I say it wasn't fast enough. Ooh, this pathway's open. Well, what's down here? Ooh, no flame geysers. That's interesting. Shortcut over here. I suppose. I can't see what's over there. Can you guys build this quick? I don't think they're going to be able to build it quick enough, though. But I want to see what's over here. Another 20, 10 pellets. I don't think I have enough for either of those. Ugh. I should probably go back to the base and see what I can make out of that. Man, there's huge pellets everywhere. But no enemies! No enemies whatsoever, so it's a low-risk area. They're getting pretty far there. Oh, I need more of my team. So I guess I'm gonna go around here and go back to the base, I suppose. I feel highly unproductive at this moment. I mean, there were the other ones that were carrying stuff back to the base, but at the same time, there's like nothing really going on in general, as opposed to getting more stuff. Maybe I should go for that 10 pellet I see over there, if at all possible, after I get finished plucking these. Oh, man. Well, I showed what's down there, aside from what's across the bridge. This is a tricky area to figure out. It's definitely would take a lot of planning because of the fact that everything is so... Oh, they're finished with the bridge. Because everything is so... I don't want to say out of the way, but it's in positions that make you use certain colors that you wouldn't normally use to traverse said obstacle. I'm going to go down here and see what's up. Actually, wait a second. Maybe what I should do is see what's over here. Oh no, wait, that loops around. My mistake. What I'm thinking of is inside this battle arena, you know, where the, Beady Longlegs was. Okay, what's down here? Huge pellets. They're already done with that wall? No, I'm not prepared for that. I was exploring that other area and, yeah. Uh-oh, where is the way out of here? Am I that lost? Well, this day is going wonderfully. Hey, wait, oh, there it is. Why didn't I see that before? Was I, like, looping too tightly or something? Anyway, I'm gonna try and get as many of these Pikmin onto stuff as I can. Okay, what's in here? Boss? No boss? There doesn't seem to be any danger at the Forest Navel in Challenge Mode, which is ironic since it's called Challenge Mode. Wait, need more. There we go. Yellows. There we go. But although at the same time, it is kind of challenging because of the fact that you have to get them to get the stuff to the base in time, if you can. I'm not gonna go for the pellets down there because that would take way too much time. I still want to see what's across the bridge, so I'm just gonna leave them to that pellet. Yeah, you got enough. Okay, I was a little worried about that, like if I miscounted or something, like I did the other parts. Yellows. Just the yellows. I got three yellows. So there we go. Alright, back over to that bridge. Wait, maybe I'll give you a pellet. Oh, there we go. Go, Olimar! To the bridge! I want to see what the heck is up on that other side. It's probably something pretty rewarding since it's so far away from base. My team is so slow! Maybe I should have used that Honey Wisp. Then again, I would probably miss some, you know, turning them into flowers and then somewhat end up being leaves and slow me down anyway. Alright, what do we have? Oh my god, it's a Pearly Clamclamp! But I have to take it on with the yellows and I'm not gonna have nearly enough time to do that, am I? Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to kill this sucker off and get done with the day. I mean, get it back there by the end of the day. Oh, no, no, no! No! Dang it. Attack the pearl. Get off. Get off. Get off. Yeah. Yeah, this is definitely a very unproductive day. Although I got some stuff back to the base. I just seen the numbers go up there. I think it's mainly because of my inexperience plus bad planning and whatnot as a result of that inexperience. Man, they didn't get many attacks off that thing. Maybe I should reposition my cursor here. That's a lot better. Just put it off to the side, I guess. Yeah, there's no way they're gonna get this back in time. But it's certainly fun to take on the clams. And there we go. Grab it, grab it, grab it, grab it, go, 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 go. Oh! Yep. Oh, whatever. I didn't notice there was one in there until it was too late. Okay, let's see here. Can I grab any of those pellets off the side and get them back in time? I highly doubt it. Like, over here is what I'm talking about. Oh, maybe if I flower them. Everyone together. That's my sound of Pikmin eating nectar. I have 25, so they can grab a pellet, but that's not going to get me very far. Yeah, they're not going to make it back, are they? Well, Try your best, guys. Alright, let's go back. Background. I think I pretty much showed the majority of the area, aside from in there, but you could tell what was down there from when I was back up to the base and, you know, where the camera was and stuff like that. Now, I just gotta make do with what I have left, I suppose. 159's not all that good considering the cap was 482. But then again, I don't expect to be world record material here anyway. Unless I put a lot of effort into practicing the runs and whatnot. Alright, red. No. Red. Red, there we go. Whoop. And no, wait, I threw it too far. Well, is that gonna work? No, it's not. There we go, I knew I could do it. Because I can't come through the water with that one, so... Oh, no, that one's assisting with the pellet, that's fine. Oh, there's a couple pellets down there. Quick, guys! Down here! I don't care if you're the wrong color. I don't discriminate. At least, not when there's this few seconds left. Go, don't take the long way. There's still time to get that back. Maybe, but those ones with that 10 pellet don't stand a chance. I don't even know where they are. They're somewhere. Well, since I'm done here, maybe I should look for them just for the fun of it to see where their progress is. Or maybe we will never know. Because that was a really long path over to where I grabbed that pellet way, way, way out in the wild. And that's it, I suppose. I think I showed the whole area. I did my best. It seems like the best pellets are around the perimeter of the place. So maybe you should be aiming for the perimeter stuff first, and then circle your way into the center as you go, if you can. And yeah, with that, I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part.